yesterday. What we are going to explain regarding this chapter 5 morphology of flowering plants. Last class we have clearly explained what is the meaning of morphology, what is the meaning of anatomy. Morphology is the change of characters externally. He is called as morphology. The study of internal characters called as anatomy. Last class we have clearly explained the meaning of anatomy, meaning of morphology. So, last class what the morphology of flowering plants. Under that, I will get to the total detail about the meaning of plant, what are the important parts of the plant, that is, first one is root, types of roots, second one is stem, what is the meaning of the system, the root is called as a root system under the soil, on the soil, the stem, shoot system. Meaning of shoot system, meaning of root system, and what are the types of roots, what are the types of stem, and other than the stem, leaves, types of leaves, meaning of leaf, importance of leaves, and flower. Flower is a reproductive organ. It supports the regeneration, how the flower helps to the offsprings, what are the parts of the flower, what are the importance of the flower in different parts like a calyx, corolla, andrecium, gynecium, all these things in relation to morphology can explain last class. Seed, fruit, functions of seed, functions of fruit, all these things we can learn. The definition of fruit, definition of seed, definition of flower, definition of types of leaves, and what are these importance like a chlorophyll, and important pigmentations will be responsible for the photosynthesis, and how to react to the growth of the root, that is a geotrophic or photosynthetic, all these points explained last class. Once you can study, if not able to understand, ask me, I will explain once again. Today we are going to part one by one. What are the components? Yesterday we can give the explanation like a root, stem, leaves, flower, fruit, all these parts, what are the changes externally, that is we study in this chapter, morphology of flowering plants. So first today we are going to study on root modification. Root modification. I think you know the meaning of root. The root is the most important organ in the plant. It absorbs the water along with the different minerals, that is supporting for plant growth. It will be development of different organ system in the plant. Hence the root there is no containing a green pigment chlorophyll because it is not exposing on the sunlight. So the root is responsible for absorption of water and minerals. In that root component, what are the modification we study? What are the modification? It will be changes in the plant. You can go to the today's class. So I think ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಸಸ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಎಲ್ಲ ಭಾಗಗಳು ಬೇರು ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು ಕಾಂಡ ಎಲೆ ಹೂವು ಕಾಯಿ ಬೀಜ ಇದೆಲ್ಲದರ ಒಂದು ಗುಣಲಕ್ಷಣಗಳು ಮತ್ತು ಅವುಗಳ ವ್ಯಾಖ್ಯಾನಗಳನ್ನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೀನಿ ರೂಟು ಬೇರು ಬೇರು ಹೇಗೆ ಸಹಾಯ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಬೇರು ಎರಡು ರೀತಿಯ ಎರಡು ವಿಧಗಳು ಒಂದು ಟ್ಯಾಪ್ ರೂಟ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಫೈಬ್ರಸ್ ರೂಟ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ತಾಯಿ ಬೇರು ಮತ್ತು ತಂತು ಬೇರು ಈ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ನೀವು ಓದ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಲ್ಲಿ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀರಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಷನ್ ರೂಟ್ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಮಾಡಿಫೈಡ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಬೇರೆ ಅಂಗವಾಗಿ ಪರಿವರ್ತನೆಯಾಗಿದೆ ರೂಟ್ ಬೇರು ಆದರೆ ಆ ಬೇರು ಬದಲಾವಣೆ ಹೇಗಾಗಿದೆ ಏನಾಗಿದೆ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನೇ ಈ ಕ್ಲಾಸಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ತಿಳ್ಕೋತೀವಿ ಅದನ್ನೇ ನಾವು ಮಾರ್ಫಾಲಜಿ ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಷನ್ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಏನು ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಷನ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಈಗ ಮಂಗದಿಂದ ಮಾನವ ಅಂತ ಏನು ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮಂಗಗಳಿಗೆಲ್ಲರೂ ಬಾಲ ಇದೆ ಟೈಲ್ ಮಾನವರಿಗೆ ಟೈಲ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಮಂಗದಿಂದ ಮಾನವ ಅಂದರೆ ಟೈಲ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಅಪೆಂಡಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಕರಳಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಅದು ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಷನ್ ಏನು ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಜಿಯೋ ಕ್ಲೈಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಹೆರಿಡಿಟರಿ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಅದನ್ನೇ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡೋದು ರೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಷನ್ ಟುಡೇ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಆನ್ ರೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಷನ್ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ದ ರೂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಶೇಪ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಶೇಪ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಟುಡೇ ದಟ್ ರೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ರೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಷನ್ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದಟ್ ರೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಷನ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ರೂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ರೂಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕವರ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಮನ್ಲಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ರೂಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಮನ್ಲಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ರೂಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ ಸೊ ದ ರೂಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ ಈಸ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ growth towards the soil. Here commonly the two reasons a fruit here the roots will be growing like this subroots here the two roots one is the region this region is called maturation region maturation region region means part maturation region this part is called colitis elongation region what is the meaning of here elongation region and what is the maturation region maturation region means it is a supporting of the subroots it will be grow on the root main root the elongation region or the area or the part is called as growth elongate growth this maturation region develops the small hairs, call it as a root hairs. Root hairs. These root hairs are supporting for absorption of minerals, water, and other ingredients towards the plant growth. This is commonly the root structure, generally the root structure common almost all the roots, even though fibrous root system or tap root system, whatever may be the common nature of the root, one is maturation region, root hairs to be produced, one more is elongated region, elongation of root growth take place towards the soil. This should be remembered, the two areas mainly occur in the roots. Now we are going to study the root modification. Based on that, what are the modifications under the root? First one, tap root system modification. Tap root system modification. Tap root system modification. Tap root system modification andre eradu type of roots nalli odidiri, ondu tap root system, innondu fibrous root system, athwa inno ondu hesaru karitare adventitious root system. Ee tap root system alli yenella modifications agide, what are the modifications under the tap root system? What modification find in the tap root system, and what are the characters of this modification, that will be studied now. So here the root modification basically under the tap root system modification, first one is fusiform root. Number one, RA fusiform. Fusiform. Fusiform root. This one will be, you should be remember, these are the modification of root system. Fusiform root system, Rhabanus sativa, say commonly radish. I think you know radish. The botanical name Rhabanus sativa. Rhabanus sativa. This is the radish plant. Majorly that I think you know what is the radish. That is in the Kannada radish mulangi. That is fusiform root. Example radish, Kannadadalli mulangi. Ee root hegirutte, what is the nature of this root? This is the root commonly, you should somewhat, you can develop the notes and also diagram. Say this is the system, fusiform root. In this fusiform root having the root modified into underground tubular part, we commonly call it as a tubular part, that is fusiform root. Here small roots will be supporting, it is a root hairs, they are absorbing the nutrients, are the some of the micro and macro molecules from the soil. That is a fusiform root. Example, Rhabanus sativa, radish. It is modified into, the root is modified into, in the form of, yeah, it is a, just like a bulge form. The upper end will be slower edge and pointed portion. It is commonly called as conical shape. Conical shape. That's why it is fusiform. The roots are conical in shape. It will be the food stuff, or it is roots of plants. They having a the different structures having modified into its particular shape will be bulging narrower under the side. It is used as a food stuff. Okay, it is a food stuff or the using as a food material. So it will be one more word. It is a storage of food. It is a storage of. This is one of the example for fusiform root under the tap root system. Okay, so here the root modified into the storage of food. This is we commonly call it as a root modification. For example, you can think of other plants. We cannot use as a food stuffs, but we can use as a food stuff. Because of this reason, it is modified. Root is modified. That is the meaning here. Morphology. Can you understand what I am explaining? The morphology is change of part root. The root converted into, it is a tubular form, radish. That is morphology. Change of external feature. Change of external character, external shape. That is the morphology. Okay. Next, we'll go to the one more type of root. Napiform root. Fusiform is over. Next is napiform. ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ. ರೂಟು ಮಾಡಿಫೈಡ್ ಆಗಿ ಅದು ಬಲ್ಜ್ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಕೋನದ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮೂಲಂಗಿ ಥರ ಬಂತು. ಅದು ರೂಟು. ಬೇರೆನೇ ಬೇರೆ ಸಸ್ಯಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಬೇರೆಗಳನ್ನು ಯುಟಿಲೈಸ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ತಿನ್ನಲಿಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ, ಆಹಾರ ಪದಾರ್ಥ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಆದರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬೇರೆ ಏನಾಗಿದೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಒಂದು ಆಹಾರ ಪದಾರ್ಥ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಅದನ್ನೇ ನಾವು ಮಾರ್ಫಾಲಜಿ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತೀವಿ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋ ಟು ದ ನೇಪಿ ಫಾರಂ ರೂಟ್. ನೇಪಿ ಫಾರಂ, ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ನೇಪಿ ಫಾರಂ ರೂಟ್? ದಿಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಬೀಟ್ ರೂಟ್. ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಯು ಸಾ ದ ಬೀಟ್ ರೂಟ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್, ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಬೀಟ್ ರೂಟ್. ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ it is a the shape will be like this. This is the common shape for this one. So this is a watch beetroot. That beetroot is also maybe called root. It will be modified. That's it, morphology. What is the shape of this napiform root? It is a root swollen. And like this, it is also some conical in nature. Conical class, what you already studied, conical class like that. That napiform root, spherically above, and also that abruptly taper below end, taper below end. This is the shape. The root hairs are commonly observed in the food material. It is also one of the type of root. It is a root modification. Here, fishy forward root, also foodstuff or food storage. This is also food storage. It is a capitalized as a food. So it is one of the model or modification of root. So this is morphology. Okay, maybe forum root. Next we'll go to the one more thing, conical root. Conical root, Docus carota. This is carrot. I think you know. Red what is that? Kempu moolangi anta kannadadalli kareethivi. Docus carota. In this Docus carota is also just like our moolangi or what we call it as radish. But they have some in the form of some short form, that's all. Almost the shape will be same. The root here is also same. That is everything almost. It will be the type of leaves will be the different. It will be the underground tap or underground tubular will be same in case of radish or in case of this Docus carota. Carrot, commonly we call it as a carrot. That is a conical root. Conical root. Conical root, it is the thing, but just a shape, based on the shape, we put it to the name conical root. That is a root modification. Here also same definition. It is a storage of food. It is a air, small air-like structures of the root, supporting for the absorption of the food and other things, minerals. See, this is commonly, we call it as a conical root. This also, the you can remember this botanical name, Docus, D-S-U-S, carota, Docus carota. First one is fusiform root example, Raphanus sativa. That is, they will ask in your examination, competitive examination, you should be remember what is the scientific name or the botanical name of radish. Okay, Raphanus sativa. And what is the botanical name of beetroot? Beta vulgaris. And what is the botanical name of Docus? That is a conical root, Docus carota. This is Docus carota. Same functions what I have given to explain like that. Next we will go to the tubular root. You should copy down once you can see the book, and you can copy and develop the skill of handwriting and also the diagram, how to write a diagram. It is the most important in your biology. You should be developing skill of writing a diagram. Okay, that is the most important. You should write with the pencil only, not using a pen. Next, that is commonly tuberous. One more, the fourth type of or fourth modification of morphology of root, tuberous root. Tuberous root. Tuberous root. I think it is one of the example for tuberous root, that is sweet potato. Sweet potato. Potato. I think you know the sweet potato. A botanical name of sweet potato, Mirabilis jollophon. Mirabilis jollophon. See, this is tuberous root, sweet potato. It is also one of the shape that is just like it is not in a proper shape. Already you know the potato, sorry, carrot, or in case of beetroot, it is having a particular shape. It is a standard shape. But in case of sweet potato, in this, the character of the scooties will be differentiating. The root will be differentiating. Or the root will be like this. Whatever may be, or it will be bulging like this. So here, there is no definite shape. It will be grow like a bigger size, that is in a sweet potato. So, first character of this tuberous root, Mirabilis jalapa, it will be only for the absorption. Here also the air-like structures on the root absorbs minerals, carbohydrates and other nutrients to the from the earth and supply to the body of the plant, and it will be support food storage material or food storage part, that is morphology of the modification of the root. Sweet potato, Kannadadalli sweet potato na genesu anta karitivi. Genesu ge shape rudu irala. For example, carrot or beetroot ge particular shape irutte, genesu ge particular shape irodilla. ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ಬಲ್ಜ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ದೊಡ್ಡದಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಚಿಕ್ಕದಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಬಲ್ಜ್ ಆಗಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಆ ಒಂದು ಶೇಪ್ ಇರೋದಕ್ಕಿರೋ ಚಾನ್ಸಸ್ ನೀವೆಲ್ಲ ಅದನ್ನು ನೀವು ನೆನಪಿಟ್ಕೋಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಒಂದು ಪಾಲ್ಮೆಟ್ ರೂಟ್ಸ್, ಐದನೇದು ಪಾಲ್ಮೆಟ್ ರೂಟ್ಸ್. ಪಾಲ್ಮೆಟ್ palmate roots, that is palmate roots aconitum. Palmate roots, they are commonly called as a branch roots modified for the respiratory nematophores or breathing roots. In this roots, especially the roots are, palmate roots are separating from the main root. They are supporting for the respiration. That is commonly called as small pores. So the pores are responsible for the exchange of gases. Exchange of gases take place means carbon dioxide converted into oxygen. That is the exchange, what our respiration take place in our body. So the lungs having a hollow lung. The lungs having a alveoli. The alveoli are one responsible for the exchange of the gases. The carbon dioxide gives out and oxygen comes inside. So this process is going on in the alveoli of the human body. Alveoli in the human body are the human lungs. Like here, these roots are modified into respiratory nematophores. The nematophores are nothing but the having a small pores in a particular root system. The spores are responsible for exchange of the gases, oxygen and carbon dioxide. It is responsible for respiration. So the nematophores are responsible for the respiration or the breathing. So it is called as breathing roots. Okay, they are last in your examination, neat examination and also competitive examination, the meaning of breathing root. The breathing roots are those, they are aconitum, in presence of aconitum or palmate roots, they are producing a supporting small air-like structures. They are all supporting for the respiration, exchange of gases take place, that is commonly called as a breathing roots. Understand what I have explained? In the Kannada, the breathing root is usrada martakke salpa martakkanta berugalu. Palmate roots alli example agutte, illi small air like structure, it will be responsible for the exchange of the gases, carbon dioxide and oxygen. That is, we commonly call it as the breathing roots. ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಬ್ರೀತಿಂಗ್ ರೂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಯಾಕೆ ಬ್ರೀತಿಂಗ್ ರೂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂತಾರೆ ಅಂದರೆ, ಇದು ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ಗೆ ಸಹಾಯ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಮತ್ತು ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಡೈಆಕ್ಸೈಡು ಇಂಟರ್ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸಸ್ ಆಗೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಸಹಾಯ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕೇ ಇದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಬ್ರೀತಿಂಗ್ ರೂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂತೀವಿ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಐದನೇ ಕಾಂಪೋನೆಂಟು ಫಾರ್ವರ್ಡ್ ರೂಟ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಬ್ರೀತಿಂಗ್ ರೂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಕಾಂಪೋನೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಟುಡೇ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ದ root modification with the tap root systems. Based on the tap root system, the most important five stages: fusiform roots, napiform roots, conical roots, tuberous roots, and also palmate roots. All these five types of roots you should be remember and learn the skill of writing a diagram of these roots. Okay, now we will go into next component, fibrous root system modification or adventitious root system modification. Fibrous root system modification or adventitious root modification. Adventitious roots, fibrous or adventitious. The spelling will be careful. Adventitious. Adventitious. 1 minute. That adventitious. Adventitious roots. Suppose it is not able to remember fibrous root, fibrous root or adventitious roots. You remember this. It is root modified into, for the storage food here also, the roots are modified into storage of food. Roots are modified into storage of food. Storage of food. It should be remembered, even dicotyledon or the monocotyledon, the roots are showing as a modified morphology. The roots are modified into storage of food materials. It's almost all the what we call it as vegetables and fruits, and what are the things we can eat in our daily life. There are also type of vegetables: potato, carrot, brinjal, all these things. Today we are explaining only for the root modification. So the example taken only for the root system. That's all. Even now bare modification and matra na otta idivi. Aa bare modification and matra na illi tilkobekagutte. ಆ ಬೇರು ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಏನೆಲ್ಲ ಚೇಂಜ್ಗಳಾಗಿದೆ, ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಅದು ಫುಡ್ ಸ್ಟೋರೇಜ್ ಆಗಿದೆ, ಏನು ಅದರ ಒಂದು ಗುಣಗಳು ಏನಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಮಾತ್ರ ನಾವು ತಿಳ್ಕೊತೀವಿ. ಆ ನಂತರ ನಾವು ಎಲೆ ಮತ್ತು ಹೂವು ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಬದಲಾವಣೆ ಮಾರ್ಫಾಲಜಿಗೆ ಹೋದಾಗ ಅದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಬ್ರಿಂಜಲ್ ತಿಳ್ಕೊತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇದು ಒಂದು ಆಹಾರ ಪದಾರ್ಥಗಳು, ಯಾವುದು ಕ್ಯಾರೆಟ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು, ಬೀಟ್ರೂಟ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು, ನವಿಲುಕೋಸ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು. ಅದೇ ಥರ ನಾವು ಬದನೆಕಾಯಿಗಳನ್ನು ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಫ್ರೂಟ್ ಇದೆ, ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ವೆಜಿಟೇಬಲ್ಸ್. ಆದರೆ ಇವತ್ತು ನಾವು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿರೋದು ಬರೀ ರೂಟ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಇರೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಆ ರೂಟನ್ನು ಮಾತ್ರ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಆಗಿ ತಗೊಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ್ಯಾವ್ದೆಲ್ಲ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅಡ್ವೆಂಟಿಷಿಯಸ್. ಯಾಕೆ ಅಡ್ವೆಂಟಿಷಿಯಸ್ ಅಂತಾರೆ ರೂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂತಾರೆ ಅಂದರೆ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕಾಂಪೋಸಿಟ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂಸ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂಸ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಟ್ಯೂಬರಸ್ ರೂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ದಿಸ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬರಸ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬರಸ್ ರೂಟ್ಸ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬರಸ್ ರೂಟ್ಸ್ what is the meaning of these tuberous fruits? What is this adventitious fruits and sweet potato? That is a what one of the example already I explained to you. Sweet potato is a one of the example for this adventitious fruits. So here, that is the root modified into the storage of food. Some examples for mohayans, vitellissima, and also the jocoma bottatas. These are the example for that. These helps to tuberous roots are helps to the storage of the food. So already this one stated the have root modification. See next component under this fibrous are adventitious roots, fasciculated roots. Fasciculated roots. Second one is fasciculated roots. What is the fasciculated roots? What is the meaning of this? Fasciculated roots occur in the form of cluster. Fasciculated roots. I think I will show you diagram how it will be. The roots are modified into. See, this is the fasciculated root. It is a bulged one. It is showing like a fasciculated. Example, asparagus and also several tuberous roots occurs in the cluster. Such roots are called as a fasciculated roots. It's a bulging. Bulging take place. The root module is a one. Then it will be going to bulging the 3-4 root nodules. That is commonly called as a fasciculated roots. Then next one is nodulous roots. That is next nodulous. Third one. Nodulous roots. What is this nodulous roots? It is a ginger. It smells like a mango. I think you know the ginger. And the ginger plant, how already you can see in the plant in the some of the agriculture field. See, this is a ginger type growing to the plant and bulging in the end. And air-like structures, they are supporting for the absorption of the nutrition and also minerals. See, this is, we commonly call it as the nodulous roots. It is in the mango ginger. It is commonly, the slender root becomes a suddenly swollen. It is the end side to be swollen at the tip. Such roots commonly called as a nodulous roots. These are found in the, what is that, this one, ginger. You know the ginger, arshina matu shunti. Shunti arshindala atrabharate. And nodules, that is supporting hydrogen circulation to support agate. Next to monifera roots. Next component. Moniliferum. Moniliferum roots. Moniliferum. Moniliferum roots. These moniliferum roots, I think we can find Crocosula moniliferum roots. Crocosula, see, this is the structure of moniliferum roots. The root having a, here this root have only bulge at the tip or the end of the root. But here the root nodules will be 3 or more. More than 1 or 2 each root. That is commonly we call it as moniliferum roots. It is a one of the morphology or modification of root system. Okay, now the modification of roots or morphology of in the flowering plants. Today we have discussed the taproot or fibrous root system, heart, adventitious food system, what are the modifications and how they are utilized for the foodstuffs. These all the things we learn today. Okay, now we are going to new concept, that is road modified for mechanical support. Road modified for the mechanical support. Road modified for the mechanical support. Mechanical support. This is the meaning of what the mechanical support. What is the meaning of this mechanical support? And how they are commonly called as what type of proofs they are utilizing as a mechanical support. I will give briefly explanation on mechanical support. Now, what I am explained till now, the route are modified into food steps or the food storage system or the food storage organs. Now we are going to route modified for the mechanical support. What is the meaning of this mechanical support? I give an example, one of the climbing plant, without supporting it will not grow. So here mechanical support of roots is nothing but the roots are supporting of the plant, it will rises or the grows towards the different age and different sizes, which supporting the root nodules or roots with in the form of soil or the some other plant or some other whatever the thing, some other supporting, all this mechanically supporting for the particular plant, the roots are supporting for the growth, is called as root modified for the mechanical support. Under that, so many examples what I quoted here. Banyan tree, the proof roots, commonly called as a proof roots. Proof roots. Here, the root, epiphytic fruit. Epiphytic fruit. Epiphytic roots. What is the meaning of this epiphytic root? That epiphytic roots are commonly called as, it is found in orchids. I think orchids are the orchids. ಪೊದರೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ಆರ್ಕಿಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಏನು ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ನಾವು ಪಾಚಂತರ ಬೆಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ರೂಟ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕಾಣ್ಬೋದು. ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ನಾವು ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿರ್ತೀರಾ, ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಗಿಡಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ರೂಟ್ಸ್ ಬಂದಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಅದು ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಸಸಿ ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಆ ಎಪಿಥೆಟಿಕ್ ರೂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಪೋರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಅದರ್ ಬ್ರಾಂಚಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಗ್ರೋಸ್ ಸಪೋರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಅದರ್ ಬ್ರಾಂಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಪಿಥೆಟಿಕ್ ರೂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂತೇಳಿ. ಅದು ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಯು ಸಾ ದ ಕ್ರೀಪರ್, ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ದೆನ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟಿಕ್ ರೂಟ್ಸ್, ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಯು ನೋ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟಿಕ್. ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್ಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಯು ನೋ ದಟ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಅನಿಮಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೀಟ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಅನದರ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೀಟ್ಸ್. ದಟ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಅದ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ದ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ ಆರ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಮನ್ಲಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್ಸ್. ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಐ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ದಿಸ್ ದಟ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟಿಕ್ ರೂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಮನ್ಲಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ಎ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ದ ಸಮ್ ಅದರ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಟ್ರೀ ಆರ್ ದ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವುಡ್ ಬ್ರಾಂಚಸ್ ದಿ ಕೆಡ್ ಡಿಡ್ ವುಡ್ ಬ್ರಾಂಚಸ್ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟಿಕ್ ರೂಟ್ಸ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ನೋಡಿದ ಫೋಟೋಸಿಂಥೆಟಿಕ್ ರೂಟ್ಸ್. ಫೋಟೋಸಿಂಥೆಟಿಕ್ ರೂಟ್ಸ್ plant here, if we growing like a daughter plants. See, I think you saw this some forest areas. When you come to the college, I will show you these are the plants. What a beautiful plants there. See, that plants are commonly this adventitious fruits. That is a leaf food, commonly called as adventitious. Already I will explain that. Then floating roots are some these floating roots are present in commonly aquatic plants. That aquatic plants are mainly cause the roots are growing towards the soil and the water. They are helpful for the dissolved oxygen in your water, absorbs and supplying for the food materials to the plant. That is commonly aquatic plants that have fruited floating roots. The plant Jessica has sporons floating roots. That root producer commonly helps for the absorption of nutrients. Finally, the roots modified in all the ways. First one is leaf, stem, and also banyan tree. The different root nodules present, they will modification of root into different characters. Those are commonly called as a morphology. Now, I think today, what are the components I will explain in relation to this root. So, just I will highlighting all the components of root. That is the root morphology. The various structures of roots, modification of root, like a food storage or some photosynthetic, these different roots, all these things becomes under morphology of root. So like same one day, next class we are going to morphology of leaf. This is morphology of what I today explain. Morphology, then we will go to the morphology of leaf, morphology of stem, morphology of fruit, morphology of flower. Let it going on study in this unit, morphology of flowering plants. I think you can able to understand what I am explaining today. So, you have morphology of flowering plants, and I will explain what it is. You have to root nodules, root, veru. ಆ ರೂಪ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಬದಲಾವಣೆಗಳಾಗಿ ಅದು ಊಟಕ್ಕಾಗ ಅಡಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಊಟ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಲ್ಲ ಆ ಒಂದು ಆ ತರಕಾರಿಗಳು ಯಾವ ಬದಲಾವಣೆಗಳಾಗಿದೆ ರೂಪಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಆದ ಮರ ಬೇರುಗಳು ಮೇಲಿಂದ ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ ನೀರಲ್ಲಿ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಕೆಲವು ಸಸ್ಯಗಳು ಬೇರು ಬಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತೆ ಕೆಲವು ಸಸ್ಯಗಳು ಎಲೆಯಿಂದ ಬೇರು ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಯಾವ್ಯಾವ ರೂಪು ಯಾವ್ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಯಾವ ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥೆಗಳು ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಇವತ್ತು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀರಿ ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಬಂದರೆ ನಾವು ಸ್ಟೆಮ್ ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಅನ್ನು ಓದ್ತೀವಿ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್ ಏನೆಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅದೇ ಮಾರ್ಫಾಲಜಿ ಸೊ ಈ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಮಾರ್ಫಾಲಜಿ ಫ್ಲವರಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಫ್ಲವರಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕ ಫ್ಲವರಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಏಂಜಿಯೋಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸು ಏನೆಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಏನೆಲ್ಲ ಮಾರ್ಫಾಲಜಿ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅದನ್ನೇ ನಾವು ಈ ಯೂನಿಟ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ಓದ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗೋದು ಇವಾಗ ನಾನು ರೂಟ್ ಮಾರ್ಫಾಲಜಿನ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ರೂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾರ್ಫಾಲಜಿ ಏನು ಬದಲಾವಣೆ ಆಯಿತು ರೂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಆಯಿತು ಅದನ್ನ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಸೊ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ದ ಮಾರ್ಫಾಲಜಿ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ಲವರಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಟುಡೇ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ದ ರೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಗೋದು ಮಾಡಿಫೈ ಆಗೋದು ಓಕೆನಾ ಅದನ್ನು ನೀವು ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಇಲ್ಲ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಏನೂ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಮಾಡಿಫೈ ಆಗ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ಬದಲಾವಣೆ ಆಗ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ಅಂತ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾನು ಫಸ್ಟೇ ಒಂದು ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಏನಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಬಾಲ ಮಾಡಿಫೈಡ್ ಆಗಿ ನಮಗೆ ಅಪೆಂಡಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಮಂಗದಿಂದ ಮನು ಮಂಗಗೆ ಬಾಲ ಇದೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಅಪೆಂಡಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ ನಾನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಅದೇ ತರ ಈಗ ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ನಾವು ಮಾಡಿಫೈಡ್ ಆಗ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ಬದಲಾವಣೆ ಆಗ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ಅನ್ನೋದೇ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ರೂಟ್ ಯಾವ ತರ ಮಾಡಿಫೈ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅನ್ನೋದೇ ನೀವು ಇವತ್ತು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದು ಇದನ್ನು ಮರೀಬಾರ್ದು ನೀವು ಮಾಡಿಫೈಡ್ ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಅದನ್ನೇ ನಾವಿಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾರ್ಫಾಲಜಿ ಅಂತ ಕರೆಯೋದು ಈಗ ರೂಟ್ದಾಯ್ತು ನೀವು ಓದ್ಕೋಬೇಕು ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಲೀಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಫ್ರೂಟು ಆಮೇಲೆ ಫ್ಲವರು ಇದೊಂದೊಂದೊಂದೊಂದು ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ನ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತೀವಿ. ಓಕೆನಾ? ಇದನ್ನು ಒಂದು ಎರಡು ಮೂರು ಸಾರಿ ಪಟ್ಟ ಕೇಳಿ, ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗಿರೋದನ್ನು ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ಸಾರಿ ಕೇಳಿ, ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ಸಾರಿ ಕೇಳಿ, ಬರ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಮತ್ತು ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ನೀವು ಕಂಪಲ್ಸರಿ ಬರೀಲೇಬೇಕು. ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಗೆ ಬಂದಾಗ ಇದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಬರೆಸ್ತೀನಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಕಡೆಯಿಂದ. ನೀವು ಬರೆಯೋ ಅಭ್ಯಾಸ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕು, ಗುಂಡಾಗಿ ಬರೀಬೇಕು, ಪೆನ್ಸಿಲ್ನಲ್ಲೇ ಬರೀಬೇಕು. ಪೆನ್ಸಿಲಲ್ಲಿ ಬರೆದು ಎರೇಸರ್ ನಡೆಸಿ ತುಂಬ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ನ ಭಾಳ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ಲಾಗಿ ಬರೀಬೇಕು. ಓಕೆನಾ? ಆಮೇಲೆ ನಾವು ಈ ಮತ್ತೆ ಸೋಮವಾರದಿಂದ ಕ್ಲಾಸಸ್ಸನ್ನು ಕಾಲೇಜಲ್ಲೇ ಮಾಡೋಣ ಅಂದ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಸಾಧ್ಯವಾದರೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ನಾವು ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಬಂದು ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಗುಂಪು ಗುಂಪು ಮಾಡಿ ಪಾಠಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. 35% ಸಿಲೆಬಸ್ ತೆಗೆದಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ತೆಗೆದುಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಖುಷಿಯಾಗಿರೋದು ಬೇಡ. ನೀವು ಅದನ್ನು ಓದ್ಕೋಬೇಕು. ಇದರ ನೀಟು ಸಿ ಇ ಟಿ ಮರೆಯೋ ಬರೆಯೋಕ್ಕಾಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಮೆಡಿಕಲ್ ಸೀಟ್ ಕೊಡೋಕೆ ಅಷ್ಟು ಈಸಿ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಹಾರ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವೆಲ್, ಯು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸನ್ನು ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಒಂದೊಂದು ಒಂದು ಡಿಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಓದ್ಕೋಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ನಾಳೆ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಗೆ ಬಂದಾಗ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್ ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ನು, ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಪಾಲಿಸಿ ಏನಾಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡೋಣ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.